Combine augmented reality, a helicopter, and an iPhone, and you get the AR drone from France-based Parrot. Unveiled for the first time at the Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas, the helicopter, or what the company calls a quadricopter, has four fans allowing it to fly in all directions. It's controlled over Wi-Fi by an iPhone or iPod Touch and makes full use of the phone's accelerometer, as tilting the phone controls the helicopter's flight. Under development for 4 years, the AR drone has two cameras built in, one on the front and one on the bottom, both of which can stream real-time video back to the phone. The chopper comes with two augmented reality games, one of which pits you against a fighter jet that you need to try and shoot. Augmented reality is when there's computer-generated imagery added to a view of the physical world.
The idea is to explore a new field of video games. Video games that you do with things. Video games that you do outside your computer display. So this is why we have built this helicopter with a camera, and the camera films the scene. But also the camera is used by a processor and it makes pattern recognition. So one of the game can be playing one helicopter against another. So it does the pattern recognition. You can shoot the other helicopter and you then get points, get advantages as a game.
In single player mode, you can play against the computer, but in two player mode, you can play against a friend who has his own copter. The AR drone has a full onboard computer and uses an ARM 926 core processor and Linux. It also has a 3-axis accelerometer, two gyroscopes, and an ultrasound altimeter.
One of the interesting features of the AR drone is it uses all the technology developed for cellular phones. It uses cellular phone CPUs, cellular phone memory, cellular phone sensors, and it has a very powerful CPU as you have on a cellular phone, and it permits to bring this level of flight quality but also processing for augmented reality.
The software running on the iPhone is open source, so Parrot hopes that developers will create more games for the copter and adapt the software to run on other devices. Parrot declined to say when exactly the AR drone would launch, only that it would be this year. It also wouldn't comment or even ballpark a potential sale price. It could be pricey, though, considering its features and components. Reporting from CES 2010 in Las Vegas, I'm Nick Barber, IDG News Service.